We will first show the reenactment of the Santo Niño's arrival in Cebu. Have a high holy mass in his honor, followed by the Sinulog. At some point during the celebration, we shall wave our white handkerchiefs in the air as a sign to the Holy Child that we are calling for his blessing and are hoping for a favorable answer to our petitions. Long before Marcella set forth in Cebu, on April 7, 1521, Cebu was already a vibrant community with its own government and a vibrant economy. By the time the expedition arrived, Cebu has metamorphosed from a sleepy fishing village to a busy agriculture and fishing, and had a plethora of religious practices, including songs and dances to their wooden idols and their leaders.
Thank you.
village, except for being covered in soot, was largely unscathed. A church was erected at the site where the image was found. The church was named San Agustin Church until 1965, when it was renamed Basilica Minor del Santo Niño. The basilica has been home to the image of the Santo Niño de Cebu, comforter of the first missionaries, and divine protector of the Philippines. Hobo. Hobo is the Visayan term for undressing. The ritual came about because there were a lot of people who wanted the honor and privilege of giving the Santo Niño his garments. Removed in the following order are the crown, then the orb and scepter, an armlet, the bands, the cape, the tunic, the inner garments, and finally the breast. With each item of clothing removed, invocations commemorating Christ's suffering and death are said.
Thank you. Houston.